Alright, this is a video of how to check to see if a mouse has got into your blower in your 2009 Toyota Highlander Hybrid. We suspect that a mouse has got into our blower because when we turned on the blower yesterday, it made a terrible squealing, crunching sound. And when it went up to full speed, it vibrated something terrible, and the whole dash vibrated. So, in thinking about it, and considering where we live, which is on an acreage in the eastern slopes of the Rocky Mountains, we have a pretty good idea that a mouse has probably got in there, and that was our first thought. But, hey, must be a mouse in our blower. So... anyhow, we left it overnight and then today went to go on a little bit of a trip, and as soon as we got out onto the highway, we could smell the unmistakable stench of rotting mouse, which kind of confirmed our fears that, yes, we probably do have a mouse in our blower, and maybe we should postpone our trip, which was going to be out to the Huckleberry Festival at Castle Mountain. And instead turn around, come home, and see if I could get the blower out and confirm whether or not there is a mouse in there. So that's the situation, and I thought, well, I did some research on the internet trying to find some instructions on how to remove the blower, and I couldn't find any, at least not for this model. So I decided, well, I'll just attack it myself and maybe make a video while I'm at it. So that's what this is. So anyways, if you have a look here, you can see this is the interior of our 2009 Toyota Highlander Hybrid. And the blower, I have determined, is down underneath the passenger dash. So to access it best, I moved the seat all the way back, and if you look down underneath, you can see a bit of a panel that seems to just snap in there with these little snaps. So you put your fingers up into those holes and give it a bit of a push, they come out fairly easily. And there's a couple fingers at the back there, pins that go into a hole. Now there seems to be something attached to this here, some electrical sensor. If you push that with your fingernail, it easily comes apart. I suspect it's, by the looks of it, it's probably a temperature sensor for the passenger side. Now, one of my first clues here is that I am seeing a little bit of mouse shit that came out of there, so that's a bit of an indication. Now, looking up inside here, you can see the blower attached to a cowling of some sort. Okay, I've had a bit of a closer look at it, and it appears that there are three screws that hold this blower in place. That's these ones here. They appear to be Torx. That one right there, a second one back there, and a third one here. And the electrical harness snaps in here. It looks pretty straightforward. It's just a little button that you'd have to press, a little clasp. You press that, give it a wiggle, and it comes out pretty straight, simply. Okay, so I'm going to grab a Torx driver that would fit that. And I'll try setting the camera down here. So hopefully you'll be able to still see what's going on. Okay. Here we are. Now I'm using this little flexible driver, which is pretty handy with a Torx bit, and it's actually a T25 bit is what fits it. Snap that in. And look to that screw at the back and remove it. And the one here. There we go. Get in there. Up. I'm holding it up with my fingers. I removed the last screw. So, there we are. Three screws. Okay. And then the whole assembly just simply drops right out pretty easily there. Oh, and I'm already seeing a tail. Yes. Sure enough, and yeah, just as we suspected, a mouse. Now how that little guy managed to get in there, I have no idea. He must have come through the air vent from outside or something. Ugh, that's disgusting. So we'll just set him over there for a minute and take another look at what we have up inside. Oh boy, it's like a meat grinder in there. Oh, we got mouse guts sprayed all over the place. You can see the cabin air filter above it. I guess I should probably yank that out and change it, and I'm going to have to figure out how I'm going to clean that cowling out. Anyway, no question about it, there was a mouse in there. So, that's the removal. Now I'm going to have to try to clean this all up with something or other, disinfect it, and it's just another addition, another chapter in our many, many stories of mouse sagas, which over the years, anybody that knows us will appreciate that we've had a lot of them. And this is just the latest. So now you know how to remove a blower, and of course putting it back in, pretty straightforward, just snap it all back in, replace the screws, piece of cake. I hope you don't ever have to be removing your blower in your 2009 Toyota Highlander Hybrid for the same reason that we do, just did. So, if so, good luck and take care. I thought I'd add an extra little piece here, an addendum to that video, because I did go ahead and manage to pull out the cabin air filter, which involves removing the glove compartment and reaching in behind and snapping it out. It's pretty straightforward. And it made it pretty clear how the mouse was getting in, because he must have come in through the air access from outside. I don't know how that ducting works, but he got through it somehow and made his way to the cabin air filter. And this is what the cabin air filter looked like. There's how he was getting in. He chewed his way right through it. And if you notice, it is right full of mouse shit. So he's been in there for a while. Hopefully he hasn't chewed through any important wiring or anything. So that's going to need to be replaced, of course, and cleaned out and sanitized. This is the spot where it goes, and you can see the top of the... That's where the blower goes in, and the carnage inside. And so he must have somehow made his way through there. So, anyways, here's the final chapter of the saga. And now I got my work cut out for me to clean this all up.